that you have when you're young, most people create themselves.
A fear of failure and a fear of success. I mean, it's a fine line between the two in my eyes.
What do you plan on doing for a living?
I didn't realize that, it was my voice.
I didn't know what else to do. You know, it's like music, I had started playing at 11 years old.
The older we get, we think too much.
You'd like for everybody to like you, but that isn't gonna happen.
You'd like for everyone to like you, but that isn't gonna happen. Wouldn't it be great if on your way to success, everyone totally 100% liked you and supported you, was there for you every step of the way? Support is great and can be crucial to your success. Support from your family, friends, even mentors. But sometimes it takes more than support to achieve success. It takes not letting your fears and self-doubts creep in and slow you down or even stop you on your journey to an extraordinary life. We sat down with people who've achieved great success, for example, in music, sports, and acting, and we asked them, along the way to your success, what fears and self-doubts did you experience? Steve Madale, the legendary trumpeter and arranger, performed at Woodstock, toured and recorded with Stevie Wonder, John Lennon, the Rolling Stones, Earth, Wind, and Fire, and performed on hundreds of albums. For Stevie Wonder, he wrote and arranged all the horns and performed on Stevie's Grammy-winning, multi-platinum album, Songs in the Key of Life. Steve Madale said,
"You can't think about fear. You trust in yourself. Intuitively, you know what you do is gonna work. Plain and simple, unquestioned.
Trust in yourself, and intuitively, you know." Broadway star Dee Dee Magno-Hall was a founding member of the all-new Mickey Mouse Club, along with Britney Spears, Christina Aguilera, Justin Timberlake, Ryan Gosling, and Keri Russell. Dee Dee then went on to become a member of Billboard's top 100 pop group, The Party. A few years later, an even bigger success came when she was cast as Kim, the lead role in what was then the number one musical on Broadway, Miss Saigon. We Skype with Dee Dee and her husband Clifton while they were on a national tour in the musical If Then, starring Idina Menzel. Dee Dee shares how she handles the pressure of performing.
You don't really have much time to think about how your nerves. You just have to jump in and get the job done.
I think the minute you start doubting yourself is the beginning of the end.
Usually we start doubting ourselves when we're young, not wanting to disappoint people who matter the most to us.
I didn't want to fail my parents. I didn't want to fail, you know, doing things wrong. I wanted to be a good student.
Frank Hamlin's strong desire to not disappoint those who mattered most to him motivated him. Not disappointing those who mattered resulted in Frank's amazing career as an NBA coach with the Chicago Bulls and the Los Angeles Lakers, winning seven championship rings.
The Los Angeles Lakers.
You can feel sorry for yourself. You can why me? And, you know, this is something I got to try and overcome. It's not fair.
Trevor Hoffman, the legendary San Diego Padres pitcher, retired from baseball with the record for the most saves in Major League history.
On the ground, Council. And there it is, Trevor Hoffman, a milestone number 600.
When Trevor blew a save, meaning he lost the game, he didn't whine, feel sorry for himself, or say, it's not fair. Singer Carol Connors was only 16 when she was discovered by the then-to-become legendary music producer, Phil Spector, who brought her into the recording studio.
It was such a struggle in the beginning because he was so dominant.
Carol did not allow Phil Spector's dominance to intimidate her. For him, she sang the lead vocal on the song that became the number one Billboard smash hit, To Know Him Is to Love Him. Later, we'll learn how Carol went on to be an Academy Award-nominated songwriter, co-writing an iconic movie theme song. Can you guess what it is? Hint, it was a knockout. In the 1970s, Jesse Davis was a well-known popular singer and film actor, but he was not a good swimmer. So, of course, he was cast in the feature film Benji Takes a Dive at Marineland, where he had to swim with sharks.
Well, I was afraid, but I decided, well, hey, I've got to do this, you know. There's no rehearsal.
Jesse was afraid of the water and sharks, and there was only going to be one take. So Jesse said to himself, I gotta do this.
Don't take chances.
Get it right. And he nailed it. As we get older, inhibitions creep in.
Because as adults, we're afraid of being judged. When you're a child, you have no inhibitions to do whatever you want.
Les Mis Broadway star Clifton Hall also played Chris, the lead in the touring company of Miss Saigon, with Dee Dee, his wife, as Kim. Clifton understands being judged is just part of the world of acting. To move past judgment, he focuses on his passion for performing. Some of us, at a young age, may not know what we want to do, but we do know what our passion is.
At the end of high school, it was like, okay, I guess I better go to college and keep studying music because I don't know what else interests me, or if there's anything else that I want to pursue.
So Gary didn't question what to do. He just knew what to do and did it. And today, he's a legendary saxophonist. He's a Grammy Award-winning songwriter. He tours with Earth, Wind & Fire, and he's recorded and performed with Whitney Houston, Phil Collins, MC Hammer, and many others. Trust, knowing, judgment, doubt, intimidation, fear, disappointment. Why me? So that's what they experienced on their journey to an extraordinary life. The same fears and self-doubts we all have. We then ask them, along the way to your success, how did you move past your fears and self-doubts?
I get butterflies all the time. I don't think that necessarily means that something's gonna happen. I feel like if I don't get those butterflies or I don't have that funny feeling, then something's wrong.
I just turned 18 in March, and in June or July, I was on the road with Quincy Jones, who was an icon. And to be in his presence and allow him to hear what I was doing, that was enough motivation for me.
It was more of a mental approach to not worrying about so many external things that I couldn't control.
I think a lot of people are that way. It's failure's not an option.
It was literally, how can I focus on what I do well and go out and execute it under extreme circumstances?
You just somehow work through it. You maybe take a different look at it from a different angle.
The way I got back to, I guess, trying to be confident on stage was I went back into myself and talked to myself when I was, 16, 17. I went back to that point where I was that little kid, and I said, and I talked to him and I said, and he was like, Clifton, this is what you love to do. This is just do it for you. Do it. You're not performing for someone. You're performing because you love to do it.
One day I woke up and I said, I don't want to be an anthropology major anymore. I want to be back in music. And I went to the end of the semester and I walked out of UCLA and never looked back. And then I wrote Hey Little Cobra, which is now considered one of the most important hot rod songs. I took my cobra down to the track, Spring Little Cobra, by the Ripcords. Only girl ever wrote a song about a hot rod that went to number one.
Hey Little Cobra, the first song she wrote that became a number one hit. And remember, I challenged you to guess what Academy Award nominated iconic movie theme song she co-wrote, that knockout song. Have you guessed correctly? Carol co-wrote Gonna Fly Now, the theme song from the movie Rocky, a Billboard number one hit. Carol String, in the face of intimidation as a singer in her teen years, led her to pave the way for female songwriters in the music industry.
I'm thankful now that I was open enough back then and humble enough to listen to someone's mentorship, because it helped me out a lot.
We all make mistakes in life, but when it came to, not being afraid to work, not being afraid to try a little bit harder, that wasn't something I was afraid of.
Well, I was determined. There was no turn back. That was, this is what I'm doing. This is what I'm going
to
do.
I'm not doing this to impress anybody. I'm doing this because I love to do it. Just like what Clifton was saying, I had to think about what's most important in my life right now. My family. My family's most important. What I'm doing right now at this moment is important to me, but it's not the most important thing in my life. My faith, my family, my friends, and the fact that I get to do what I love to do for a living.
Embracing fear and self-doubt, accepting mentors, staying focused. Success is an option. Keep perspective. Believe in your childhood passions. It takes work and determination, faith, family, and friends. They embrace these principles and it set the stage for their journey to an extraordinary life.
I didn't need to go much further out than family to provide what it meant to be a good person and to have confidence in yourself and to be able to have a work ethic that dictated what you were going to do in the game.
Attitude kind of carried over and it kind of helped me along through my career and helped me in other situations and opportunities that came along later in later years.
Time's ticking, tick, 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 tick. And you better be in the moment. You better be in the moment.
And so when I get nervous or when I get scared, I try to bring it back to what's most important in my life. And then everything else becomes so small. Do you know what I mean? Like in the big scheme of things.
If motive and intent are in the right place, that everything else falls into place. If you chase something, it'll never happen.
You know, one of the greatest winners of all time, Michael Jordan, he refused to lose. And you know, he's gonna lose some games. I mean, you know, he's missed a lot of big shots. There's a commercial that he did the one time. He missed a lot of big shots, missed a lot of game winning shots. But he was gonna take the next one and it was going in.
They shared their journeys with us, their fears, self-doubts, and how they worked through them. Then, to our surprise, they went even deeper into what it takes to have an extraordinary life.
You must have laser beam focus. You must say, this is what I want, and at all costs, this is what I'm gonna go for. If you don't eat it, sleep it, think it, drink it, need it, forget it. That's what it takes to be focused.
That, you know, I worked hard and I was fair and tried to prepare guys to the best of my ability.
If you're gonna listen to other people and worry about what they say, you're not gonna be very happy, I don't think.
You just have to do what you have to do. And you hope that you're doing the right thing, you know, because you're not always doing the right thing. You know, everything don't always turn out to be perfect or right, you know. And so you have to pick yourself up and start all over again.
You know, if you have a great attitude, professionalism, and, genuine courtesy of how, you know, and how you treat people, it will have a positive impact on your career.
It kind of goes back to that work ethic, and my dad was a former Marine, or is a Marine, that fought in World War II, and we talked about it with my older brother today. He goes, Dad, how'd you get through, you know, Iwo Jima? And he goes, I just dug a little deeper. And for me, digging a little deeper ain't sticking a needle in your ass so that you can be a little bit stronger and you can go out and play a little bit harder. It's sucking it up and getting it out of your gut.
It's like you take one road or you take another, and depending on which road you take, your life can change drastically or not. Maybe you make a change or maybe you make a choice and your life still happens the way that it's supposed to happen.
Real life stories from people just like you and me. Stories that reveal how you can move through your fears and self-doubts without them slowing you down or even stopping you on your journey to an extraordinary life.